everyone, welcome to online class of financial accounting 3. I am Akila Bai, assistant professor and head department of commerce, Sri Venkatramana Swami College, Bandwal. Today in this video I am going to start with the first chapter of financial accounting 3, that is admission of a partner. As I said in the previous video, all the 6 units that you are going to study under financial accounting 3 during this semester is relating to partnership accounts. The concept of partnership accounts you have already learnt in your PU classes. So now, before we take up the concept of admission of a partner, let us discuss the basic concepts now, okay? All the rules and regulations relating to Indian partnership business is laid down by Indian Partnership Act of 1932. The Indian Partnership Act of 1932 gives the definition of partnership as follows. Partnership is the relation between persons who have agreed to share the profits of a business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. Which means that partnership is the relation between persons. So in order to start a partnership business, at least there must be 2 persons who are agreeing to start a business in a lawful way. So the relation between persons, for example, there are 2 persons called Mr. X and Mr. Y. Mr. X has the idea to start a new business and Mr. Y has money. So one day Mr. X goes to Mr. Y and explains his idea to start a new business. Then if Mr. Y is interested in investment, then those 2 persons can join together to start a new business. Such a business organization is called partnership firm because there are 2 persons who have agreed to start a new business in a lawful way. So let us come back to the definition. Partnership is the relation between persons who have agreed to share the profits. Agreed means there must be agreement between the persons or among the persons who are starting a partnership business, and the agreement which is in the written form is called partnership deed. So they are making the agreement to share the profits. So in the future, whenever the partnership firm is making the profit, that should be shared between or among all the partners in the business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. Which means that the business or partnership firm can be carried on by all the partners actively, or any one of them will actively take care of the business and other persons will just make the investment. Okay. So here the persons who are actively participating in the business of the partnership, they are called active partners, and those partners who are going to just make the investment but not active in the business, they are called sleeping partners. Okay. So this is the definition given by Indian Partnership Act. Now let us take up the concept of admission of a partner. So here we need to first understand the meaning of admission of a partner. Admission of a partner means taking a new partner into an existing partnership firm. A new partner can be admitted only with the consent of all the existing partners unless otherwise agreed upon. Which means that admission of a partner means taking one more new partner into an existing partnership firm, taking the permission or taking the consent of all the existing partners. If the existing partners are not willing to take the new person as a partner, then that new person cannot be admitted as a partner. So then here the next concept we have to concentrate is reasons for the admission of a new partner. There are a number of reasons. Let us see one by one. The first one, for securing additional capital for the partnership business. So here the existing partners might be in the intention to expand their existing business, but they may not be in a position to contribute that additional capital. So what they will do, they will take one more person as a new partner who will contribute that additional capital so that they can expand their business. So that is the first reason, for securing additional capital for their partnership business. Then second one, for securing additional managerial and technical skills for the firm. So this could be the second reason for, you know, securing additional managerial and technical skills for the firm. The third reason is for availing the business reputation of the new partner. So the new partner might have good reputation in the society as well as in business market. So the existing partners will think that when the new partner is admitted into the existing business, his reputation is going to help them to gain good profit in the future. So that could be one more reason. Then the next one, for avoiding competition from competing businessmen. So here, if any person is competing with the existing firm, then the existing partners might think that if we take that person as a partner, new partner in the existing partnership business, then there will not be any competition, so that they can avoid the competition. So that could be another reason. And the next reason is for expanding the business to enjoy the benefits of large scale operations. So this is almost similar to the first point. So if they want to enjoy the benefits of large scale operations, then also they can admit one more person as a new partner. So these are the reasons for the admission of a new partner into an existing partnership firm. Then the next one is ratios to be calculated at the time of admission of a new partner. Here we have to calculate two ratios. The first one is sacrifice ratio and the second one is new profit sharing ratio. So these are the two ratios we have to calculate at the time of admission of a new partner into an existing partnership business. So we have to discuss these two ratios in detail. So let us take up the first ratio now. Here the first ratio is sacrificing ratio or sacrifice ratio of old partners. Sacrifice ratio or sacrificing ratio refers to the ratio in which old partners sacrifice or surrender a part of their share of profit to the new partner on his admission. So in simple words, sacrifice ratio is nothing but it is the ratio in which the existing partners are surrendering or sacrificing a part of their share of profit to the new partner on his admission. Let us suppose that firm had a profit of rupees 1 lakh and there were two partners who were equal partners. So what is the profit sharing ratio between those two partners? 1:1. Now how they are going to distribute that rupees 1 lakh profit between them? 50,000 each. So first partner 50,000 and second partner 50,000. Okay. So this is the situation before admitting a new partner. Now the new partner is going to be admitted and the partners have decided to continue with the same ratio, that is they want to have an equal ratio. So earlier there were only two persons, now there is one more partner, so the equal ratio is 1:1:1. Now let us suppose that the firm is earning same rupees 1 lakh profit, then if you are going to distribute that profit among all the three partners, so what is the profit they are going to earn? That is 33,000 plus. So now if you compare, earlier the first partner was getting 50,000, but on the admission of new partner he will get just 33,333 something. Okay, coming to the second partner also, he was getting 50,000, but now on the admission of new partner he will get 33,333 something. Okay, so if you compare now, the existing partners have sacrificed or surrendered a part of their share to the new partner on his admission. That is why their share of profit has reduced. So the ratio in which the existing partners have sacrificed their share of profit to the new partner on his admission is called sacrifice ratio. I think you understood the concept. Now let us see the need for calculation of sacrifice ratio. Sacrifice ratio is required to be calculated for the purpose of distributing the goodwill brought in cash by the new partner among the old partners. Okay, so here understanding this point is very very important. The sacrifice ratio is to be calculated for the purpose of distributing the goodwill brought in cash by the new partner among the existing or between the existing partners. Now why the new partner has to bring in goodwill in cash? As we discussed in the example, the existing partners are surrendering or sacrificing a part of their share to the new partner on his admission. Okay, so for sacrificing a part of their share of profit to the new partner, they should be given some compensation. So whatever the goodwill the new partner is bringing in cash, so that will serve as a compensation to the existing partner. So that is why we have to calculate the sacrifice ratio so that the compensation can be distributed in the same ratio in which they have sacrificed the share of profit. Okay, so I'll come again. The sacrifice ratio is the ratio in which the existing partners are sacrificing or surrendering a part of their share to the new partner on his admission. So now the sacrifice ratio is to be calculated for the purpose of distributing the goodwill brought in cash by the new partner between the existing partners in the sacrifice ratio, because that serves as a compensation. When the sacrifice is done in the sacrifice ratio, then the compensation which they are distributing between the partner, that should also be done in the sacrifice ratio. That is why we have to calculate the sacrifice ratio. Then let us see the regarding the calculation of sacrifice ratio. Sacrifice ratio is usually the difference between the old profit sharing ratio and new profit sharing ratio. Please remember, sacrifice ratio we have to calculate only with regard to existing partners because they are sacrificing. Okay, so the sacrifice ratio is the difference between old profit sharing ratio and new profit sharing ratio. So when you take the difference between old profit sharing ratio and new profit sharing ratio, you will get the sacrifice ratio. But sometimes, depending upon the information given in the problem, we have to apply different ways in order to calculate the sacrifice ratio. There are in total 7 cases to calculate the sacrifice ratio. In this video, I have covered only 3 cases. So let us see those cases one by one. The case 1 says, problem gives the following informations. The first information that will be given in the problem is old profit sharing ratio of the old partners, second one, share of the new partner, and the third one, the problem also states that the old partners continue to share the future profits in the same ratio as before. So these 3 informations will be given in the problem. So in such a case, what is the sacrifice ratio? Sacrifice ratio is equal to old profit sharing ratio. So when old profit sharing ratio of the old partners is given, share of the new partner is given, and also state that the old partners or the existing partners are going to continue in the same in the future in the same ratio as before, then you need not go for any calculation. Sacrifice ratio is equal to old profit sharing ratio. Straight away you can take the old profit sharing ratio itself as the sacrifice ratio. But if you want to do the verification, we will do that with an example. In this example, it is given that X and Y were partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. They admit Z for 1/3 share in the future profits. X and Y agree to share the future profits in the same ratio as before. Calculate the sacrifice ratio. Okay, as we discussed in the case 1, 3 informations will be given in the problem. The first one is old profit sharing ratio of the old partners. In this example, there were 2 old partners, X and Y, and their old profit sharing ratio was 3:2. Okay, this is the first information. Then second information, the problem gives the share of new partner. In this case, the new partner is Z and his share in the future profits is going to be 1/3. Then the problem also states that the old partners are going to share the future profits in the same ratio as before. So here also it is stated that the old partners, that is X and Y, are going to share the future profits in the same ratio as before. Means their future sharing will be 3:2. Okay, on this basis we have to calculate what is the sacrifice ratio. The case 1 says that we need not calculate what is the sacrifice ratio. Straight away we have to take the old profit sharing ratio between the old partners itself as the sacrifice ratio. In this case, old profit sharing ratio between X and Y is 3:2, so that itself is going to be sacrifice ratio. But we will verify that with the example. So here, first we have to write what is the old profit sharing ratio between X and Y, that is 3:2. Then in the next line, we have to write what is the share of new partner Z in the future profit. It is given that it is 1/3. And then we should also write what is the ratio of sharing the future profits between the old partners. It is given that they are going to share the future profits in the same ratio as before. Before they were sharing in 3:2, and now in the future also the ratio of sharing the future profit between X and Y is going to be same, that is 3:2. Okay. After that we have to assume that if the total share of the firm is 1. So we have to write, let the total share of the firm, entire firm be 1. Okay, then we have to calculate what is the remaining share of the firm after giving the share to new partner, that is Z. Okay, how to calculate that? The total share of the firm is 1. From that, if we deduct the share of new partner, so remaining is 2/3. Okay, so this is the remaining share of the entire firm after deducting the new partner's share. Okay, now on this basis we have to calculate what is the new shares of X and Y on the admission of Z. How to calculate that? We have to write what is the remaining share. So here in case of X, let us see how to calculate. First we have to write what is the remaining share. So here the remaining share is 2/3 into, we have to multiply what is their old share. Okay, so old share of X was 3/5. So when you multiply, it is in the numerator you will get 6, 3 2s are 6, and in the denominator 3 5s are 15. So
X new share is going to be 6 by 15. Then in the same way, we have to also calculate for partner Y, the other old partner. So again, the remaining share is 2 by 3 into the old share is 2 by 5. So when you multiply 2 2s are 4 divided by in the denominator 3 5s are 15. Okay, we can also write what is the share of Z. It is 1 by 3. To equate the denominator, we have to multiply it with 5, both to the denominator as well as numerator. So you will get new share of Z as 5 by 15. Now we have to calculate what is the share sacrificed by each of the old partner. That is how much X has sacrificed and how much Y has sacrificed. So how to calculate that? Share sacrificed by each of the old partner is equal to old share minus new share. So in case of X, the old share was 3 by 5 minus new share is 6 by 15. So in order to equate the denominator, we have to multiply 3 to the first part here. So both to the denominator as well as the numerator. So we will get here in the denominator 15 and in the denominator we will get 15 and in the numerator 3 3s are 9 minus 6 we will get 3 by 15. So this is the share sacrificed by partner X. Similarly, we have to calculate in case of Y. So here in case of Y, his old share is 2 by 5 minus his new share is 4 by 15. So when you simplify this, in the denominator we should get 15. So we have to multiply 3 to both the numerator as well as denominator. So the denominator is going to be 15. In the numerator it is 2 into 3, 6 minus 4. The remaining answer is 2 by 15. So you came to know that. So X has sacrificed 3 by 15 and Y has sacrificed 2 by 15. So these are the share sacrificed. So now these share sacrificed should be taken into consideration to calculate the sacrifice ratio. So therefore sacrifice ratio is equal to 3 by 15 is to 2 by 15. So since the denominator is equal, we have to directly take the values in the numerator, that is 3 is to 2. Therefore the sacrifice ratio here, case 1 says that sacrifice ratio will be equal to old profit sharing ratio. What is the old profit sharing ratio of X and Y? It is 3 is to 2. So we have verified that the sacrifice ratio is equal to old profit sharing ratio when case 1 is applicable. So in whenever we solve the questions, we need not again calculate where the case 1 is applicable. Directly we have to take what is the sacrifice ratio. Sacrifice ratio is equal to old profit sharing ratio.
Then coming to the second case, the problem gives the following information. The first one, old profit sharing ratio of the old partners will be given. Second one, share of the new partner will be given. And the third one, the problem does not state as to how the old partners share the profits in the future. Okay, which means that only two informations will be given. That is old profit sharing ratio of the old partners and share of the new partner. In this case, how to calculate the sacrifice ratio? So now, what is the difference you notice between the first case and the second case? First point, it is similar. Second point is also similar. Only with regard to the third point, in the first case, they will specifically give that the old partners are going to share the future profit in the same ratio as before. But here, in the second case, that sentence will not be given. So in that case, what you have to do is, you have to make an assumption that the old partners are going to share the future profit in the same ratio as before. Now, when you make that assumption, there is no difference between the first case and second case. So, what is the sacrifice ratio? Sacrifice ratio is equal to old profit sharing ratio. You need not again do any calculation. As we have seen in the example, straight away you can take the old profit sharing ratio itself as the sacrifice ratio. Okay, so this is about case 2. Then coming to case 3. The problem gives the following information. The first one, old profit sharing ratio of the old partners will be given, share of the new partner will be given, and the third one, it also states the ratio in which old partners sacrifice their profits to the new partner. So here, these three informations will be given. If you see the third information, the problem states that the ratio in which old partners sacrifice their share of profit to the new partner. So now, what is the meaning of sacrifice ratio? Sacrifice ratio is the ratio in which existing or old partners are sacrificing their share of profit to the new partner. So in the third case, this ratio will be specifically given in the question, so you need not do any calculation. Okay, straight away whatever given in the question or problem, that itself can be taken as the sacrifice ratio. So this is how we calculate the sacrifice ratio in first three cases, that is case 1, case 2 and case 3. So there are another 4 cases which we are going to discuss in the upcoming video. Okay, so that's it for this video. Thank you for watching.